Welcome back. We are on the topic percentages. In the previous video, we solved two questions on percentage error. In this video, we are going to solve another question on percentage error. The question for this video is, a student measured the length of a pipe and obtained 3.99 meters. If the percentage error of his measurement was 5% and his measurement was smaller than the actual length of the pipe, what is the actual length of the pipe? So let's assume that this is the pipe that the student measured its length. We are being told that the student measured the length and he had 3.99, but in his measurement there was a percentage error of 5%, and the measurement that he obtained, that is 3.99, is smaller than the actual length of the pipe. This means that the actual length of the pipe is longer than 3.99. We are being told to find the actual length of the pipe. Since we are looking for the actual length of the pipe, we are going to let a variable to represent it. So we are going to let x represent the actual length of the pipe, meaning that the length of this pipe, that is the actual length, is x. The measurement the student obtained was 3.99 meters. We know that percentage error is equal to error divided by the actual value times 100. We have been given the percentage error of the measurement as 5%. We also know that the error is equal to the highest value minus the least value. The question told us that the actual length of the pipe is bigger than the measurement the student obtained. That is, x is bigger than 3.99. So if you want to find the error, the highest value here is x, and the least value is the measurement the student obtained, which is 3.99. So the error, which is the highest value minus the least value, will give us x minus 3.99, because x is the highest value and 3.99 is the least value. Now we have the percentage error as 5%. We have the error as x minus 3.99. So we can find the actual value, which is x. So we have percentage error as 5%, error as x minus 3.99, and the actual length as x. We know that percentage error is equal to the error divided by the actual value, in this case the actual length, times 100. So we are going to substitute this information into the formula here. We have the percentage error as 5, the error as x minus 3.99, the actual value or the actual length as x, then times 100. Here, we did not bring the percentage sign because of the 100 that we have here. The 100 here indicates that 5 is already a percentage. So because we have times 100 here, we are not going to bring the percentage sign. So the percentage error in this case is 5. Now we have a linear equation. X is the actual length of the pipe, so we have to find x. We know from here that 100 here is the same as 100 divided by 1. So we have x minus 3.99 divided by x times 100 divided by 1. So x minus 3.99 will multiply 100, then x will multiply 1. That is, the numerator multiplies the numerator, then the denominator multiplies the denominator. When we do that, we are going to have 5 is equal to 100 into brackets x minus 3.99 divided by x. Since x minus 3.99 is a binomial and is multiplying 100, you are going to put the binomial in a bracket. In the videos on binomials under the topic algebraic expression, we explained this into details. X times 1 will give us x. Now, to make x the subject or to find x, we are going to multiply both sides by x to cancel out the fractions. When you do that, you can see from here that x will cancel x. So you multiply the left hand side by x and you multiply the right hand side by x. You have x times 5, which will give us 5x. Then here, since we have cancelled x and x out, we are going to have 100 into bracket x minus 3.99. So you go ahead and we open the brackets. This will give us 5x is equal to 100x minus 399. We group like terms and we simplify. When you do that, you are going to have minus 95x is equal to minus 399. Then you divide both sides by minus 95 and x will give us 4.2. So all this is linear equation, and we have solved a lot of linear equations under the topic linear equations. So if you watch that video, you know how to solve this type of linear equation. So as soon as you get to this level, you open the bracket, then you group like terms and simplify. When you do that, x is giving us 4.2. That means that the actual length of the pipe is 4.2 meters. So the student measured it and he had 3.99 meters, but the actual length of the pipe was 4.2 meters. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe to this channel for more videos. In the next video, we are going to consider another application of percentages known as discount. So we will learn more about discount and how to solve problems involving discount. Bye-bye.